Hi, everybody. I'm Tom Pico, president of the chamber, and I'm spending a few minutes with each of the 9 candidates that are running for a seat on our chamber board of directors this year so that you have a chance to get to know them better. Annually, our members have the opportunity to elect 3 people to the chamber's 18-person board, and then our existing board elects 3 more members from the remaining pool of candidates so that we have 6 new board members each year. The first phase of our election, where you as our members get to vote, will run from October 2nd through the 16th. And remember that each business or nonprofit member gets just one vote. I'm pleased today to have Laura Tracy from Bangor Savings Bank with me. And we're going to get to know a little bit more about Laura today. So thank you for being here. And thank you for stepping up to offer your support of the chamber in this way. So.
Thank you for having me. I'm very excited to be here.
Absolutely. So tell us a little bit about you. Where's home, and what's tell us a little bit about who you are.
So I am a native. I grew up right in Warren.
Right.
You know, one town over. I live in Waldo right now. I have 3 kids that keep me going. And I also love to hike, and I fly airplanes.
That's great. Thanks. So you're at Bangor Savings Bank. Tell us a little bit about your role with the bank.
So I'm in the Rockland location as their assistant branch manager. I pretty much do anything you need. Come to me for loans, you know, open accounts, can do any of that. My favorite part about being here at the bank is that they're really involved in the local communities, and they encourage all of their employees are as well. So it gives me a chance to get out and do the things I've been looking to do.
That's great. And you're relatively new. How long have you been at the bank now?
I've been at the bank since January.
Yeah. So right before COVID. What a great time for new job, right?
Yeah. A really interesting way to learn about banking.
Yeah, for sure. So how has, just from your short time there before that hit to now, how has banking changed, or how has your ability to interact with your customers changed?
I mean, we have run the gamut from in the very beginning. We were open and I was seeing people all the time, although I was away at training quite a bit. Mm-hmm. And, you know, starting in March, we shut down. So we were still here and we were still able to help customers, but it was over the phone, over email, through the drive-thru. And we did that for several months.
Right.
We opened up back in June. Now we have people here all the time.
Yep. That's great. So tell a little bit about your career before Bangor Savings Bank and what brought you here. So
before that, for 6 years, I worked for Maine Boats, Homes and Harbors. I helped manage the show. I sold advertising in the magazine as well as online. Before that, I worked at Back Cove as an HR manager. And prior to that, I was a stay-at-home mom and college student.
That's great.
Been an adventure to get here.
Yeah, super. That's great. Are you other stuff? And you talked a little bit about you're a pilot, right? But so I'd love to hear a little more about that. But any other things that you do outside of work, or community nonprofits you're involved with, or things like that too?
I am not currently involved in any nonprofits. In the past, when I was at UROC for school, I was the president of their student association for several years. Mm-hmm. Prior to that, I was the vice president of the PTA in Warren. I didn't really have the opportunity to be out and involved so much in the community in my past jobs, but sure. Again, I have that opportunity now, so
right.
I'm really excited to take advantage of it.
That's right. So talk a little bit about the chamber. You certainly have been somebody that's been active both with Maine Boats, Homes and Harbors and with Bangor Savings. And back when we could get together in person more frequently, you certainly were engaged with the chamber. So just talk a little bit about why it's important to you, a couple of things that might be, you know, things that stand out to you about why the chamber is important, events that we do or things that the organization does to support businesses in our communities.
Sure. So I believe that the chamber is important to our area because our businesses are primarily owned by members of our community. They're really the smaller mom and pop shops that don't have the corporate backing when times get tough, like, you know, now. Mm-hmm. Our family and friends to succeed, but we also need them to thrive, to continue to drive our economy. I feel like 2 events or, you know, programs that the chamber does that I really find valuable are the business after hours, of course, is one I really love to attend. I love it for networking, but I love it more for the fact that, you know, I can bring my employees. They're young and they want to get involved in the community, but they don't know where to start. So it's like an easy non-commitment. Just show up and hang out for a little bit. Let me just introduce you to some people.
Right.
I mean, they're really looking forward to when that is able to happen again.
Well, we are too.
Me too.
Yeah.
Also, I feel like the Chamber Gala is really great. And I chose that as one of my favorites because I feel like it's really nice to witness others being praised for their successes and to be able to have the opportunity to celebrate with them. I mean, there are times that I'm so involved in my own life that I might not see that, you know, I might miss something. And being able to see that and be there with them is really great.
That's great. Thank you. So are there things, you know, I guess I'm trying to get at what inspired you to think about running for the Chamber Board. Are there things that you feel like you bring to the table or things that you'd like to see the Chamber do that we're not currently doing right now? And we're certainly always looking to evolve and add new things and new ideas. So any thoughts about what you would bring to the table or ideas that you might add to the organization?
Sure. So I think I would be a great addition to the board because, you know, I have had lots of time to enjoy the Chamber and I would love to have a chance to, you know, bring the new energy, the new perspective, and maybe some outside the box thinking, just a fresh set of eyes.
Mm-hmm.
I think that with the current situation, it's a little more difficult to try to get people together and figure out the best way to help support our businesses. I know that we've all done a lot of Zoom calls.
Right.
My kids even are like, no more Zoom. So then it's sort of, you know, what can we do that's social distancing? How can we still support these businesses without getting on Zoom calls all the time? What can we do to get together from afar, from outside, and how can we support each other? I'd love to help figure that out.
Super. That's great. Anything else that you want to share with our members before we wrap up?
I mean, I feel like I've really said it, but I'd really be excited to be part of the board and to be involved. I've wanted to for a lot of years now. I love the Chamber. I love the events you put on. And I would just love to have the chance to give back.
Super. Great. Well, Laura Tracy from Bangor Savings Bank, thank you very much for spending a few minutes with me. And we really appreciate your engagement with the Chamber. And we certainly appreciate your willingness to step up and take on a larger role. So thanks again. And hope you all get a chance to tune into our other interviews with our other board candidates as well. Thanks.